What's up, guys? So today I want to do a review of this Pik Rite Hydra-Ram manure spreader that we've been using here for a little while now. It's a push spreader with vertical beaters, and I'm just going to go around and talk about a few different aspects of it. Just give my thoughts on it. So this is a push spreader, so rather than having the paddles and chains that go around to bring the manure to the back, it just has the front wall push back and push the manure straight out. And that's a really nice design. I just like the simplicity of it, and you're not dealing with a lot of different moving parts. It's just that simple hydraulic push coming back. And the unique thing about these Pik Rite spreaders is it's not just the front wall that's moving. There's actually a part of the floor there. It's about a third of the floor or so there that moves along with it. So I have the push going back right now. Just want to show you how this works. So right now this bottom cylinder is pushing out, and it's pushing the whole thing forward, and the floor here is actually going front. You can see it moving right here. And this is just a really nice feature because it's gonna get that whole pile moving. Rather than just kind of packing at first and maybe spilling some over the sides, the entire pile gets going and starts pushing out the back right away. So you can see that floor here is working towards the end. Once it gets to the end here, it'll stop, and then that push will just continue coming back against towards the back. So there it's against, and now it's separated, and this back part's coming alone. And you can see what's going on back here. That second cylinder's running, and the floor is the whole way up towards the end here. And so you're gonna get that even flow of manure the whole way until the spreader's completely empty. And I like how these are curved right here, right around the beater, so it cleans out really well. Gets everything out of the spreader. And that's a really nice setup. That's what we're used to with our old John Deere 785 manure spreader. Pik Rite actually got the rights to that design from John Deere, so it's pretty much the exact same design as our old spreader. Another nice thing about push spreaders is you get that constant flow until the spreader is completely empty. If you have like an apron chain on the bottom, what'll happen is once you get to the back, it'll fall down, and then it'll just come slow for the last little bit. It's just really nice with the push spreader. It goes until it's empty at full speed, and then you can reverse it and head out of the field right away. This is a vertical beater manure spreader. So our old spreader has a larger beater on the bottom and a smaller one on top horizontally, and it just kind of tosses the manure out. Doesn't really do a great job at breaking up the clumps, but this spreader, it's a huge difference. It really does a nice job at just spreading it wide. The spread pattern's a lot wider, and you don't have to feel like you got to fly through the field to get a nice thin layer of manure down. It's something that we've been wanting for a long time, to get a vertical beater spreader. It's definitely a feature we like. These things do take some power, especially when you start it up. You can really feel it in the tractor, just getting the PTO started. We do a lot of no-till planting, and having a spreader that really breaks up the clumps and spreads it thin is important to us, just because we don't want to go in there with any tillage equipment. We just go straight in and plant, and that's kind of how a lot of our acres are managed. So having a spreader that does a good job with that's important. Another thing I like about the design of this spreader, it has a direct drive from the hoy from the tractor straight back here to this gearbox. Powers the beaters off of that. I just like the simplicity of that. Our old spreader would have had a chain in the front, and then the power motor ran along the side of the spreader, and that was just more moving parts to give issues. And I just like the simplicity of this, just straight from the tractor and underneath the spreader the whole way back through. Now this spreader has a lift gate on it, and it's right here. It just lifts straight up, flips up over top there, and that's definitely a must to have on a manure spreader. We used to have one that didn't, and if you're holding a sloppy manure or something and you want to go on the road, that doesn't work. So having that's very important. So that just lifts up nicely out of the way. And they have this rubber right here because these vertical beater spreaders can throw some clumps back towards the tractor, and you need to have something there to block them. That seems to do the job. I know there's some spreaders like this that have a higher front end to protect the tractor a little bit more, to make sure nothing gets thrown up that way. It's nice not having that there, so you have a little more visibility. As long as that rubber there holds up and blocks everything, I haven't had any issues with it, but it seems like a good design to me. Now, one thing I didn't love about this spreader, the tongue is pretty long. It trails pretty far over. When you go around a turn, you really gotta take it wide because it does trail in pretty far. I'm assuming that's for good reason, but it is actually about 3 feet longer than the tongue on our old manure spreader. So I guess that's why I noticed the difference. That's not a big deal, but it's just something that I wouldn't mind if it was a little bit shorter. Something else that's nice about the spreader is all the grease fittings are lined up in easy to reach places. So there's a set of four there. There's a couple other ones you have to find along the sides here. But in general, it seems like a pretty easy machine to maintain. Something we haven't tried, but they were telling me about it. This whole back end will lift off. You have to take these bolts out, and then there's just, I guess you gotta take the PTO shaft off the bottom, and then you can just lift it up. There's hooks up top, and you can actually lift the beaters off the back if you want to stockpile like over the winter or something. So that way you don't have to run the beaters to unload. You can just push the load out the back and just pile it somewhere to store. This spreader has the big tires on it, which is important because we want to reduce compaction. We're really fussy about trying to stay out of the fields if it's muddy and wet. And if we do have to go in the fields, we want to have wide tires on the machines to try to reduce that compaction. One thing about these though is they do stick out kind of far. So if you have a, depending on what you're loading with, it can be a little hard to reach over. Our large skid loader with the big bucket on it does fine. We can easily load. If we're using our smaller skid loader, it actually is a little bit tough to reach in too far to load the whole spreader. But we're actually pretty used to it. Our old spreader is basically the exact same thing. So it's not something that bothers me too much, but depending on what you're loading with, that could be in the way for you. Now, one of the big selling points on this spreader for me is this little tube right here. And look at this. Take your beverage of choice. Look at that. Fits right on in there. Now, I did find some papers in here when I opened this up. Don't need them. Threw them away. But that's convenient right there. Put the cap on. And I find that during the winter time, it'll keep a drink ice cold. This spreader also gives you the ability to control the speed of the flow into these cylinders that push it back. So you can really adjust it to get the exact speed that you want. Our old spreader, we didn't have that ability. So it was kind of just by the tractor adjustments, which we always had as slow as we could. It was still not slow enough. So having that's always handy. With this spreader though, the nice thing is since it spreads so wide, we don't have to feel like we need to fly through the field and run it really slow because it's really spreading the manure out nice. And so that's something that's nice. With our old spreader, I would go in high gear, flying through the field at 15 plus miles an hour to get it out wide enough. I mean, to get it spread out thin enough. I can keep the tractor in a low gear. I can even run the push a little bit faster and it still spreads it nicer and thinner into the field. So that's it for my review of the spreader. So I got some news for you guys. We actually did buy this thing. So it's staying. We've been wanting to get a vertical beater spreader for a while, and we were trying this one and we worked out a deal with Pik Rite, so we're very thankful to be able to keep this thing here. It should last us a long time and do a great job for us. I want to thank Pik Rite for offering to bring it out here and letting us use it.